So there we go. That was Carl. Please make a big round of applause. Well, didn't get the chance to tell you, of course, he fly the two kites there, and that's a total of four lines. So he's using a control bar in his right hand with the two lines connected to it and control bar in his left hand. Total of four lines. Clever stuff. And if all goes well, we'll see more from Carl shortly with the multiple kite flying. Right, now it's time to go back to more of tradition, where we've got Brian and Carl coming together, flying two of their kites. I think these are based on the North Shore Radical, and they, Brian, I think they were, yeah? Yeah, that's right, I think they are. So they're a very strong and a good tracking kite. As the guys set up these kites, you always want to watch out because there could be some surprises. So have your cameras, phones, or tablets ready to get some pictures as they go into their pairs routine. Right, so we're getting ready. They're getting ready for their display. Carl just checking in with Alex. Alexander, of course. Get it right, Paul. Spectrum. Are you ready?
Thank you.
Oh wow, what a display.
Wasn't that amazing, Paul? And I believe they were the 120 feet tails. Brian will correct me if I've
correct.
I've got the thumbs up.
120 foot. And of course they were just painting the sky with colour, weren't they? Nice breeze there as well for them put on display. I was over here with Alexander, another member of the ground crew there. And he's in his pushchair here. And he was quite animated when the kites were in the air.
He was following them tails all the way.
Yeah.
I did ask him what he thought of it and he just went...
I know. Yeah, well, that's Alexander all over.
But as I quite lyrically have said on previous occasions, Paul, behind every good man there's a good woman, and Jan was behind them too
Jan was out there, yes.
Ensuring that they were staying within the arena, making sure the kite stayed in the air. And then Georgina was down the other end.
She was over there. Georgina was all over it, actually. Yeah.
She's now got the enviable task of winding up the 120 foot tails,
yeah. Right, so now, that was good. We're going to come back to the multiple kite flying aspect. And we've seen Carl flying two kites. And we're really going to juice things up now. And we're going to go for three kites. Three kites flown independently.
Just hang on one minute. Hang on a minute.
Oh, yes.
We already know he's flown one kite in one hand.
Yep.
One kite in hand two.
Yeah, with the control bars.
So...
How is he going to fly the third?
Where does he fly the third?
Right,
then?
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think some of you are ahead of us. He's got a harness around his waist, of course. So the third kite is going to be flown, no hands. So literally, he's going to be flying the third kite from the waist. So kite one is right hand, kite two in his left hand, and the third kite from around his waist. That's going to be a total of six lines to juggle independently. Then he's got to get them into formation. It'll be a bit like the red arrows on strings. And then he's got to choreograph it all to music as well. Now that's if it all goes well. Remember, there's a very narrow margin of error with this. If anything goes wrong with one kite, it's sort of likely to be game over for the display. So,
now, there aren't many people in the world that can do this either.
There's very few. In the world, there's around about, we believe between about 12 and 15 that we know of. And up to display standard in the UK, less than one. Well, I'll go so far as to say there's about Kate. Carl is probably about the only one that I know of. There's one other that I know of, but I think Carl surpasses any of them in his expertise. So there we go. Very lucky to have him here. He's got the kite set up, all on different length lines.
We've got the music set up.
The music's all ready. We're just waiting for Carl's signal.
Yeah.
That's the go, right? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please pay attention. This is an extremely difficult display from Carl, the one-man team.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel.
That's kite one.
Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by. It's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good.
Here we go then.
Shimmy sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on a tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And the world is a new world, and a whole world for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, how cool was that? Oh, they love that, Carl. That's what I'm talking about. Amazing. Juggling six lines there and the whole thing set to music. It doesn't get better than that. Absolutely great finale to their first part of their routine this afternoon. We're going to see more from the guys later on this afternoon. And Carl, I can tell you that Alexander is very animated over here. There was loads of oohs and ahs going on. He did very well, didn't he, Alexander? He did very well. But actually, we've got a reasonable breeze here today. And it's nice and comfortable for you as spectators as well. So what a great day. Just make sure that you drink plenty and that you do protect yourself from the sun, which is coming through, trust me, from behind those clouds there. So do make sure that you drink plenty and that you keep safely protected from the sun's rays. So in the arena at the moment, we've got NASA Man setting up.
Now his kite is named NASA Wing because originally when the space shuttle was being launched and bits had to, parts of the shuttle had to come back to Earth, they needed a parachute to bring it down, and they found the parachute wasn't suitable, so they had to design something else, and the designers designed this kite.
NASA Wing kite.
And several people thought, well, actually, that's quite a good kite for traction. I'd like to pull my buggy on that, or I'd like to landboard with that.
It was a parachute form, which was then taken on by the kite fraternity and turned into a power kite. So yeah, its origins, as you quite rightly say, Kate, from the NASA space projects. And what happened is, if he's successful here, he'll steer it with the front wheel, with his feet, using the power, just powered by the traction from the kite. Quite difficult here, obviously, because we have got the hill to contend with. So we'll see how we get on. Certainly we can demo it. Whether we've actually got enough strength in the wind to bring us up the hill, I'm not quite sure. I don't think so, but we can go and do a few cross-field demos.
Now, when we talk about the wind window, we are talking about the area of sky that
sort of arc, really, isn't it? An arc in which you can fly. You're quite right, Kay.
So depending on which part of the arc the kite is in at the time will depend on how much power that has in it. In the up top part of the arc, the kite is at its most powerful. To the left or right, it is at the least. As you can see, as he moves around, you'll see how much the kite pulls him when he's in that centre part of the arc.
Yeah, absolutely right there, Kay. That mid part being the power zone, isn't it?
That's it, and that's what he's looking for. He was a bit concerned beforehand because he did say it's quite strong out there today. Well, it's a gentle breeze, but for kite flying like this, it's reasonably brisk, so he's quite pleased. So he's hoping to be able to give you a good display today.
Always trickier here on Royston Heath. Winds will play various tricks as it goes round the hillside. But so far, so good. It's freshening now, you can feel the wind picking up.
Now in America, I believe they have done some land speed records with the buggies and the kites to see how fast and how far they can go. And I believe the top speed was 60 miles an hour.
I believe it was around that, yeah.
Over a course of something like half a mile.
And of course, looking over the far side of the arena are land yachts over there. Of course, that's their expertise in this as well is well known. So their expertise in making use of sailing on land, if you like.
Yeah, because we've got, as well as having the buggy to fly with a kite, you can do it with a land board, which is kind of like a skateboard, but with harnesses on so that you stay attached to the board and then you get pulled along by the kite. You can also use it for kite surfing. A lot of that I know is done at Hunstanton. And,
yeah, very popular sport, one of the extreme sports, Kay, yeah?
Yeah. Actually, there's quite a lot of competitions for that now.
Thank you.